Hello, everyone, and thank you for tuning in PTV's sports coverage of men's basketball. As we are here live at the Prudential Center, I am Ronnie Jerez, joined by Ben Harris, as the men's Pirates team defeated the Marquette Golden Eagles 57-51 at home as they extend their winning streak to now three, as they won three in a row, and they have now won six straight against the Marquette Golden Eagles. Now, Ben, what is something you saw in this game that really led to the Pirates' victory in this one?
The Pirates played great defense. They started out the first half in a 2-3 zone, changed things up here and there in the second half, but that 2-3 zone in the first half really showed off what the Pirates can do defensively. They held the Marquette Golden Eagles to some of the worst shooting they've had all season, Ronnie. I mean, Marquette couldn't buy a bucket at some points, ending the game shooting 30% from the floor, a pitiful 12% from behind the three-point arc. The Golden Eagles just couldn't get much going, and it led to Seton Hall's sixth straight victory over Marquette.
And now this is they swept the Marquette Golden Eagles, not for the season. So they've won out entirely against this team, and they've been playing very well against this team for now a couple seasons now. But in this game, we started off a very slow game. It was a slow game from start to finish, as it was a low-scoring game, 57-51. And you don't really see that with the Pirates, but now this adds on to their total of if the Pirates leave the team under 70 points, they're undefeated. So the defense have definitely stuck up recently in games. But I want to highlight a player. The leading player for the Pirates was Jared Roden, as he finished with 20 points and 7 rebounds. And Jared Roden loves playing at home. We've seen many 20-point game performances here at home. What did you see from him today that you really liked?
Look, Ronnie, I said it pregame. I thought that as of late, it has been all Mamu and all Kale. They've been the talk of the town. Everybody's talking about, Miles Kale is kind of returning to that sophomore form where he can prove that he can be a do-it-all swingman. But this game was about Jared Roden getting back into form, dropped 20 points, was stuffing the stat sheet, 7 boards, 4 assists, so he's creating for his teammates as well and making plays on the defensive end as well, 1 block and 2 steals. The man does it all. Jared Roden is one of the hardest working players on the Seton Hall team, and I can't even think of a more exemplary game than this one that showed that.
And we saw that 20-point performance, but we also saw a 10-point performance from Shavar Reynolds, who has been very quiet recently. He's been scoring maybe 2 points, 3 points, and getting into a lot of foul trouble. I mean, today with 4 fouls as well, but
Shavar did very well, yes, driving to the lane and then shooting floaters and then also being able to create for his other teammates by driving to the lane as well.
Yes, he's almost kind of patented that move of driving and then stopping and fading away right in the paint for a really short jumper, and he played outstanding today. And Mamu Kalish really finished with 11 points, kind of underperformed what, we could have expected from him.
But here's the thing. I think Mamu did what he needed to do. It wasn't an outrageous scoring outburst that he was able to provide, but the man got 10 rebounds. I mean, he put up numbers that, yes, he could have done more. There's a lot of guys on this team that could have done more. This game was very flawed today. As we said, it was very slow and defensive-based, and you can't win every game just based off hoping, forcing your opponent to miss shots. Sometimes you have to go out and get more buckets yourself. But that wasn't necessary today because the Pirates did the dirty work. Guys like Mamu chipped in, not as much as you may usually see them in terms of scoring, but everybody did their part, and it earned the Pirates a victory.
And one thing we've noticed and we mentioned during the halftime report was Jahari Long getting a lot more playing time, a lot more minutes. And Bryce Aiken, he suited up today, but he didn't really play. So there's some speculating between us that it could be an injury or who knows, because Bryce Aiken has been playing well so far. But Jahari Long, what are your thoughts on his performance today and his role is stepping up with Bryce Aiken on the bench?
You know, Jahari Long plays like a freshman point guard. He's very tentative, and you can see that he's thinking about every move that he makes on the court. And don't get me wrong, he made some very smart plays, but a lot of them just didn't go exactly how he wanted them to, per se. Like, there was one point where he turned the ball over because he tried to throw an outlet pass in transition ahead to Tack Molson, and it just there was miscommunication and it didn't work out. But he has good ideas, and you can tell that he's developing and trying to get better as a playmaking point guard. I just really think Jahari Long has a lot of potential, and while he may not have had just a spectacular performance or anything, I think he contributed in ways that you don't really see that much on the stat sheet.
Speaking about another freshman on the other side for the Marquette, they have a phenom of a freshman in Dawson Garcia, averaging 13 points for the season, and he finished with 0 points today. That speaks to a lot of the Pirates' defense holding him to that 0 points. What are your thoughts on his lack of performance for Dawson?
Look, man, this Pirates 2-3 zone shut Garcia down. He wasn't able to do anything. I mean, like you said, 28 points against Nova is no easy feat. So for the very next game to be able to hold him to such little production is all credit to Kevin Willard and the Pirates' defense.
And now that they swept them, what do you think this win means for the tournament chances that the Pirates may face, as they now have to win out, or they went through that really struggleless, you know, point in the season with Creighton losing, getting swept by Creighton and Villanova, but this is a big bounce back win for them.
Yeah, I mean, this is a nice three-game streak they're on. Granted, it hasn't been against the top opponents of the Big East after struggling against them so much, and like you said, getting swept by both Creighton and Villanova this season. But putting games together in a string is very important, and I think they have a very good chance to up this streak from 3-4, as the next game is against DePaul, who is not much of a competitor, the final 11th place team in the Big East as we sit here right now, and of course beating the Golden Eagles, the 10th place team today. So the Pirates are beating who they should beat, and for the most part competing against who they need to compete against. Things didn't go their way against Creighton or Villanova, and that's tough to swallow. But I don't think Pirates fans should be too discouraged. I think they keep defeating who they are supposed to beat, and they should expect a tournament berth. I mean, third in the Big East, ahead of UConn. Right now, all the experts are projecting that the top four seeds in the Big East are all going to make the tournament. So I think just play every game individually. Don't get ahead of yourselves. And see what happens at the end of the season. See what happens with the Big East tournament. I think this Pirates team is in a very good position to have a March Madness berth.
And after this win, they now move to 12-8 on the season. Like you said, third in the Big East. In good company when you have the top two teams being Villanova and Creighton. And speaking of getting ahead of ourselves, we're going to do that a little bit right now. The next game is against DePaul, and last game, they played against DePaul. They were up big at the half, but then they had an epic meltdown where they didn't score for 9 minutes, closing out that second half. They still edged away with the win. It was very, very scary for Pirate fans everywhere. But do you think they have that game in the back of their mind and they want to see if they can close out against a DePaul team that's at the bottom of the Big East?
Yeah, only winning by 8 against a DePaul team that struggled so much, and especially being up 12 at the half. First half against DePaul, they led 40-28. So to have that margin get shrunk for the final score wasn't something that sat well with the Pirates. I think as long as everybody comes out and does what they're supposed to do, I mean, don't get me wrong, DePaul has a lot of talent, especially in guys like Charlie Moore and Romeo Weems. But I think next game should be a pretty easy victory for the Pirates.
Well, next game, stay tuned for PTV's coverage, as we will be there and we will see. But that's all from us here at the Prudential Center in Newark. For Ben Harris, I'm Ronnie Jerez. Once again, the Pirates defeat the Golden Eagles 57-51. We'll catch you guys on the next time. Please be safe.
Bye, Mom.